A few summers ago, my brother called me up and says, "Can you play softball this summer?" I say, "Yeah, I probably could." He says, "Great, I got the old team together, our little league team. I got all the guys." Oh, I said, "Steve, no, we were terrible. We went 0-2, 0-2 years. We never won a game. You could look at us and see we were all bound to be future accountants and thespians." He said, "No, you've got to play. I've got Dick's Bar to sponsor us. Dick's Bar, the Medici's of softball. At Osseo High School reunion, you could tell somebody you discovered the cure for cancer, and they'd go, 'Oh, that's nice.' But if you said, 'And I play for Dick's Bar,' they'd say, 'What? You're kidding. Hey, what are you drinking? You want another one? This is my sister. Let me praise you, for you are a god." So I say, "Yeah," to my brother. I say, "Yeah, I'm in." Okay, at our first game, I look at our team, and they're the same guys. They're a little grayer, a little heavier, but it's the same guys. One thespian and nine accountants. The other team hasn't shown up yet, so we take infield practice. My brother hits a ground ball, and pocket protectors and reading glasses go flying. I say, "Maybe we should have rehearsed." "Too late," says my brother. "Look, the other team arrives, strapping young bucks in uniforms, uniforms stretched to the limit over muscle and sinew. Our guys look shaken, but from years of playing softball, I know young guys can be beat. They've got the passion, but not the craft. Watch out for church teams. A lot of aggression comes out on softball night for church teams. Also, beware any team with dog in the title. Team with goofy names like Jerry's Atrix or Foul Balls, they're usually just that, goofy. Teams with initials followed by the words construction or refrigeration, look out." Our team, Dick's Bar, takes the field, and the game stays close. And then around the third inning, the sun sets. Okay, now this is Minnesota, so it's cold. It's like 30 degrees, freezing. And we're all in jackets and stocking hats. My brother's in his duck hunting outfit. Camouflage, boots, Gore-Tex hat, and the score remains tied to the last inning. We take our positions in the field, and before I pitch, I look around to make sure everybody's in place. My brother's in the outfield, laying flat on his stomach, all camoed up. Like he's duck hunting in a blind. I figure all he needs is a bunch of other softballs around him for decoys. I pitch the ball, and sure enough, the batter hits it to center field. My brother jumps up, mimes a gun, aims at the ball, and goes boom, boom, and catches it. Now our team is excited. Hey, we could win this thing. It took 30 years for this day. The bottom of the last inning was spectacular, and this is exactly how I remember it. All right, I'm up first, and before I know it, cursed by fate, two strikes threaten to end my night. The other team is yelling, "Swing batter, swing batter," and I'm thinking, I have been. Wait, I say, wait, time out, for God's sake, time out. Then grabbing another weapon that suited my grip, I say, "Quickly, men, quickly, bring me tape, lash me to the bat, and stuff my ears with Bazooka Joe so I may not hear their taunts." My crew did as I bade, and stepping forward amid taunts falling harmless now, I am rewarded by three straight balls and an easy sailing to first base. Cheers from my friends in arms. But wait, this new land is guarded by a man, half god, half man. I know him to have but one eye, for when he did bat, his comrade shouted, "Good eye, good eye." The giant asks my name. "Nobody," I reply. "Well, nobody, this is the last land you shall see." But I caught the eye of the batsman, and we did employ the old hit and run. "Watch nobody," shouted the giant. "He's running, get nobody. His team is confused. My comrade is out, but I stand safe on the next island, which is occupied by one who plies me with sweet words, seductive words. You should stay right here," he says. "You're safe. I've heard you on the radio. You should be on our team." His words of honey tempt, yet when our next batter flies out to right field, I tag up and run to third with all my might. Safe now, I shed hot tears for the one who sacrificed to move me forward. Oh, how I feel old. The third baseman, would-be suitor of this victory, taunts me. "You old man, in rags, body old and weak, you are obviously from the island of Thesbos." And he laughed, making sport of me. "This victory is ours, and you shall never make it home. How dare this young suitor court the victory, the one I love?" Now my brother steps to the plate, black beard standing like an oak, truly the son of our father. Our third base coach, trusted old sage, speaks in good counsel. "Two outs, run on anything." And as my brother with a mighty force swings the bat, I run the path well-worn by past armies, armies greater than myself. I run toward home, Athena, daughter of Zeus, at my side, bidding me on, until a warrior, ruddy complexion, blocks home plate. I smash into him, sending him man and orb flying. As I lay outstretched, bat still lashed to my wrist. Zeus himself, disguised in mask and armor, lord of this flat world, proclaims me safe at home. Oh, how the heady wine did flow. The young suitors stood stunned, their wives and children's groaning in grief and tears, renting garments, tearing hair, shrieking like birds of prey. We convene at Dick's bar, high back chairs, mellow wine in golden cups. And when we had put aside desire for food and drink, extra cheese on mine, bathed in burnished tubs, warmed with fleece, till Athena closed my eyes with welcome sleep. And when young dawn with her rose-red fingers colored the sky, I awoke in my old bones again. The bat now sits in the corner of my office, tape on the handle, and I await my brother's call. Thank you.